Christmas is 17 days away.
Now, isn't it?
Hey. Want to pick that come off?
Yeah.
Ugh. Silly microphone. I might need a new microphone.
Isn't this fun? Technical difficulties at the last one.
Okay, anyhow, I'll talk loudly until I can get this thing hooked back up. It must have popped out. We on?
There we go. We're back. Jeez. Boy, I'll tell you what. Professionalism is my middle name. Christmas is only 17 days away. As many of us have probably guessed, there's a lot of shopping left to do. And if you're out there searching for the perfect gift for your loved one, especially your little kids, you want to make sure it's safe. And December is also Safe Toys and Gifts Month. And this morning we have Julie Noble from Lee Health with us, breaking things down on what we should be aware of when we're getting gifts for the kids this holiday season. And Julie, thank you so much for coming with
Thank you for having me, Greg.
Yeah, we really appreciate it. So what toys should we be looking out for?
So the hard facts on toy safety, in 2016, we had more than 174,000 children admitted to the emergency departments under 15 years of age for toy-related incidents. So that's like 477 per day. Half of those under the age of five.
And they seem preventable, too. Just have to be on the lookout of what you're doing.
They are, absolutely.
What's fascinating, too, is we have a couple of examples that we brought in. Now, at first glance, these just look like nice, soft, plushy, you know, cuddly kind of toys. But I guess one of these two is something we should avoid.
Right. So my mother-in-law makes these toys for children at Golisano Children's Hospital. And when you are shopping for toys for children, pay particular attention to their age, their developmental level. You want to make sure that you're reading the instructions on the side and also any warning labels, right? Some pieces and parts of toys can cause choking hazards. So if you look at this toy right here, all of the parts and pieces are built into. So there's no choking hazard.
Okay.
However, on this little toy, there's a button. So buttons and batteries and magnets pose particular challenges and hazards for kids. So we really want to be careful of the pieces and parts then and make sure everything's intact, make sure that the playtime is supervised.
Right.
Kids love to put things in their mouth, right?
I've got
their ears,
Everything is tested with the mouth first.
Right.
It can be alarming, and it's amazing how fast kids are too. Because you think you know you have something out of their reach or what have you. All it takes is a second and a half for them to just reach out and grab it.
That's but also, it's usually
In the mouth. What I found interesting too is maybe avoid some vintage gifts or something along those lines.
They can pose a problem with. Like lead poisoning.
Right.
Some of those
like
heirlooms that you pass around. Exactly. So you want to be careful of that. You want to particularly pay attention to the riding toys. Mm-hmm. If you are going to buy a riding toy for a child, like a skateboard, a scooter, a bicycle, make sure you get a consumer product certified helmet for that child. If I can mention, we have a spike in ATV injuries coming into the Children's Hospital right now. So that protective gear is really going to help keep kids out of the Children's Hospital and keep them safe, keep them alive. It's really important to wear the helmet, wear the safety gear.
100%. And it's not just toys, too. I mean, it can just be fun decorations around the house.
Absolutely. So, you know, Christmas tree and ornaments and a lot of children are seen in, like, over 3,000 a day are seen in the hospital around the Christmas time for those ornaments. So if you have, and so those ornaments that break or glass or sharp pieces, you want to put those on top of the Christmas tree where your little ones can't reach them, and then more, you know, children safe decorations down at the bottom. And make sure with your Christmas tree that you are checking regularly for water levels, because we don't want them to dehydrate and the needles to get all brittle and cause a fire hazard.
What are some suggestions you would have for families who might have kids considered special needs or something along those lines, autism or
sensory? I'm glad that you brought that up. Absolutely. So that's what you want to look for. You want to look for toys that appeal to their senses, the textures, the sounds, the bright lights. And then pay particular attention to the packaging. Make sure you remove any plastic or hard or sharp edges to the packaging that could hurt or injure that child.
Excellent. Yeah. Great information, Julie.
Thank you.
Thanks for coming in this
morning.
Thank
you.
Wish you the happiest of holidays. Sorry, my microphone didn't want us to have this conversation. We got to fix it. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
All right, 9:26 is the time. We got to take a time out, but we are back in just a moment.